trial in court today.
Under pressure, Dr. Peter Galvan agreed to turn over thousands of documents. Galvan is under fire for the way his office spends public money. His office has until 11 a.m. Friday to give 80,000 internal emails to the state legislative auditor. But he is fighting to keep 2,000 emails private. And as North Shore reporter Heath Allen tells us, the judge will decide if those documents will remain confidential.
We're talking about public employees using public computers on a public system.
Faced with St. Tammany Parish Coroner Dr. Peter Galvan's reluctance to turn over internal emails subpoenaed by the state, Legislative Auditor Daryl Papera took the coroner to court. The state legislative auditor, attempting to force the embattled coroner to turn over thousands of internal emails sent among him and his top staffers. The legislative auditor, just one of a number of agencies investigating the operations of the coroner's office, from his spending of taxpayer dollars to vacation time. At issue, about 80,000 internal emails from the St. Tammany Parish Coroner's Office. Many, he says, are privileged. Attorneys for the coroner's office had already balked at the subpoena, saying many of the emails are, quote, protected by attorney-client privilege or contain confidential personal health information that is prohibited from disclosure. So both sides found common ground this week and this morning took it to the judge. The 80,000 emails not privileged will be turned over.
They said that they will present about 2,000 documents to the judge that they consider to be privileged. It's now up to the judge to decide if those documents really are privileged. If they're not privileged, they'll turn them back over to us.
Attorneys for the St. Tammany Parish Coroner's Office maintain the St. Tammany Parish Coroner's Office continues to cooperate fully with every agency. But attorneys for the legislative auditor say getting the necessary documents has been difficult.
This is the first time we've had to do it to this extent in my 13 years with the auditor.
No timeline on how long it might take the judge to review the 2,000 emails that might be considered confidential. The rest of the 80,000 emails must be turned over to the legislative auditor by Friday morning at 11. On your side in Baton Rouge, Heath Allen, WDSU News.
The coroner's office has until Wednesday to comply with a similar subpoena from the state attorney general's office. A spokesperson for the AG says the coroner's office is, quote, in the process of complying and has agreed to do so. And